Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to do a video on regression, but I'm really not touching on this deeply at all. I just want to give you some vocabulary just so you can kind of understand what it is. The regression line, or line of best fits, or line of least squares line, is the straight line that best fits the scatter plot of the data. The regression equation is y hat equals b sub 0 plus b sub 1 x, which algebraically describes the regression line. This is the equation we use if we have a sample statistic. If we had a population parameter, we would use a very similar line that's shown down here. So we use beta instead of b. Sometimes you'll also see that equation written as y equals a plus bx. Depending on which calculator you have, they might use a and b, and sometimes they might see those b and a switch. So you have to be careful about what equation is actually being used. You should recognize that as related to the y equals mx plus b formula. And in fact, in our equation up here, b sub 0 is the y-intercept and b sub 1 is the slope. So what I just want to show you, when they say the least squares criteria, every time you have some points, and here's our 4 points here, each of those points has a distance from the line. And that distance from the line is called the residuals. And the vertical distance between the line of best fit and each observation. And that just means that we predicted that the y would fall here, but the actual y falls there. And so we can look at that. And we can do the squares of those as we talk about the least squares. We want to find the line that has the smallest value as we do the squares of those residuals. In this case, the line going through here is the line of best fit. It's the one that creates the smallest distances between all those points. And in this particular one, they do use A as the point where it crosses the y-axis, which would be your y-intercept, and B as the slope. So that's one. I just wanted to show you that. And then we can see here, we have a line. Here's the equation of that line. The 0.14 shows us the slope of that. The 1.33 shows us where it would cross the y-axis. And then we have the residuals are these places, the distances from the line and the actual points that we found. So that would be a line of best fit right there. Just a couple of others I wanted to show you. You could have a relationship that is negative. This one's looking at the life expectancy in years compared to the cigarettes smoked per day. And you can see when there's fewer cigarettes smoked, you have a longer life expectancy. The more cigarettes you smoke a day, the shorter your life expectancy. And this is the data set they use to plot that. So they plot the scatter plot, and then they find the line of best fit using the technology, which is what I would use, whatever technology they use, but we're going to use StatCrunch to do this for us. And so I did create that video already. And here's another one. There's a bunch of points, but the line of best fit goes right here. And you can imagine having to do that by hand. It's really nice to have that done for us. So once again, the residual is the difference between the observed value, sample value of y, and the y value that is predicted by using the regression equation. So it looks like y minus y hat. This is the one we predicted. This is the one we actually had. Or opposite of that, excuse me, observed and the predicted. So we have those residuals. That is sort of like, oh, that didn't fall exactly on the line. If we have a regression equation, we can use it to make predictions about other x and y pairs. So for example, suppose in 20 families, the IQ scores of the oldest child, which we'll call x, in a family is paired with the mother's IQ score, which we'll call y, and a regression equation for the data set is y hat equals 13.45 plus 0.91x. Predict the IQ score for the mother if a child's IQ score is 118. Whoops. Sorry about that. And so we just take the regression equation and we replace the x with the x we were just given, because x represents the child score. So we replace that with the 118, plug that into our calculator, and we get a prediction for that particular child. The mother's IQ score we would predict would be about 121. So we can just plug a value in to get that, to make that prediction. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.